Hello, in today's video, we shall learn in detail about bacteriophage. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about the structure of bacteriophage, its mode of replication with lytic and lysogenic cycle along with their differences. Let us begin with the introduction to bacteriophages. Viruses are infectious agents with both living and non-living characteristics. Bacteriophages are viruses that infect and replicate only in bacterial cells. They also infect the single-celled prokaryotic organisms known as archaea. Bacteriophages attacking Escherichia coli are called coliphages or T phages. Bacteriophages are obligate intracellular parasites and are dependent on host cells for their growth. They remain inactive outside the host cell and require host cellular machinery to carry on with their metabolic activities. Bacteriophages are species specific with regard to their host. They are simple organisms consisting of a core of genetic material surrounded by a protein capsid. The capsid protects the genome from degradation. The genetic material may be single-stranded RNA, double-stranded DNA, or single-stranded DNA depending on the phage type. Next, let us study the structure of bacteriophage. A bacteriophage consists of a core of nuclear or genetic material surrounded by a protein capsid. It consists of a polyhedral head, a short collar, and a helical tail. The head consists of 2000 capsomeres with the genetic material enclosed in it. The genetic material may be single-stranded RNA, double-stranded DNA, or single-stranded DNA. The tail is cylindrical and composed of an inner hollow tube called core, surrounded by a contractile sheath with 24 annular rings. The distal end of the tail consists of a basal hexagonal plate that has spikes or flexible tail fibers at each corner. There are three basic structural forms of phages: an icosahedral 20-sided head with a tail, an icosahedral head without a tail, and a filamentous form. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share this video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, we shall look into the life cycle of bacteriophage. The life cycle of bacteriophage comprises of the entry of the virus into the host cell, its replication, and exit from the host cell. During infection, a phage attaches itself to a bacterial cell and inserts its genetic material into the cell. Then, a phage follows any one of the two life cycles, namely lytic or virulent cycle and lysogenic or non-virulent or temperate cycle. In the lytic cycle, the phage takes over the machinery of the host cell to make the phage components and to produce its viral progeny, killing the host in the process. The various steps involved in Lytic cycle are adsorption, penetration, synthesis of phage components, maturation and assembly, release of the progeny phages. First stage is adsorption. The phage particles come in contact with the bacterial cell. Attachment sites on the bacteriophage attaches to the receptor sites on the host bacterium cell membrane by means of tail fibers. Specific strains of bacteriophage only attach to specific strains of host bacteria. Second step is penetration. During penetration, the tail sheath of the bacteriophage contracts. The base plate and the tail fibers are held firmly against the bacterial cell. A bacteriophage enzyme weakens a part of the cell wall, makes a hole in the bacterial wall. The hollow core is pushed downward, and the bacteriophage injects its genome into the bacterial cytoplasm. The empty head or capsid and the tail remain outside the cell. Third stage is the synthesis of phage components. The viral genome takes over the host cellular mechanism to produce components of new virus particles. The subunits of phage, head, tail, and proteins appear. The nucleus and cytoplasm also contain the components of the phage. Fourth stage is maturation and assembly. On maturation, the head and tail protein of phage DNA spontaneously assemble, and each component of phage DNA gets surrounded by a protein coat. The tail structures are added, resulting in the formation of a virion or infective virus particles. Final stage is release of phages. The progeny phages are released by the lysis of the infected bacterium. The breakdown of the bacterial peptidoglycan is brought about by a bacteriophage-coated enzyme lysine. Eclipse phase is the time interval between the entry of phage nucleic acid into the bacterial cell to the appearance of first infectious intracellular phage particles. To summarize, during Lytic replication cycle, a phage attaches to a host bacterium. The phage genome is introduced into the host cell cytoplasm. The host cellular machinery is utilized to manufacture capsid proteins, tail proteins, and phage genome. They assemble to form multiple copies of the bacteriophage. Lysis of the infected bacterium takes place, releasing the new bacteriophages to infect other host cells. Next is the lysogenic cycle. In lysogenic cycle, the phage incorporates the viral genome into the host cell genome to undergo replication, but does not kill the host cell. In lysogeny, the viral genome, after adsorption and penetration, does not take control of the host machinery. Instead, the viral genome gets integrated with the nucleoid of the host genome. The integrated phage DNA is known as prophage, and the bacteria containing the prophages are termed lysogens. The prophage genome replicates along with the host genome. This cycle is seen in lambda phages that attack Escherichia coli. The phage involved in this cycle is a temperate phage. Thus, the new composite genome replicates as a single unit. The genome multiplies several times to produce daughter lysogenic bacteria. If a bacterium with prophage is exposed to different factors like temperature fluctuations, UV light, or chemicals, the viral genome may detach from the composite genome, get released in the cytoplasm. This dissociation is termed induction. The viral genome enters the Lytic cycle, forms temperate phages that get released from the host bacterium by lysis of the host cell wall. Next, let us differentiate between Lytic cycle and lysogenic cycle. During Lytic cycle, lysis of the infected cell takes place. In lysogenic cycle, the host is not killed by the viral phage. Viral DNA in Lytic cycle does not integrate into the host DNA. In lysogenic cycle, the viral phage DNA is integrated into the host cell DNA. There is no prophage stage in Lytic cycle. Lysogenic cycle has a prophage stage. In Lytic cycle, host DNA is hydrolyzed. In lysogenic cycle, host DNA is not hydrolyzed. In Lytic cycle, viral DNA replication takes place independent of the host DNA replication. In lysogenic cycle, viral DNA replication occurs along with the host DNA replication. Lytic cycle completes in a short span of time. Lysogenic cycle is a time-consuming process. Productivity of viral DNA is high in Lytic cycle. Productivity of viral DNA is low in lysogenic cycle. In Lytic cycle, the host cellular machinery is taken over by the viral genome. In lysogenic cycle, the host cellular machinery is not completely taken over by the viral genome. At the end of Lytic cycle, a progeny of virus are produced. In lysogenic cycle, there is no production of viral progeny. Lytic cycle does not allow genetic recombination in the host bacterium. Lysogenic cycle allows genetic recombination in the host bacterium. The virus is virulent in Lytic cycle. The virus is avirulent in lysogenic cycle. Finally, let us understand the uses of bacteriophage. Bacteriophages can be used as an alternative to antibiotic therapy. They can fight against bacterial infections, including those that have become resistant to treatment with antibiotics. Bacteriophages can be used in manufacturing vaccines. Bacteriophages can be used as biochemical agents in agriculture. They can preserve the quality of food products. Bacteriophages are responsible in controlling bacterial growth in both human and animals. As lytic bacteriophages invade and kill the bacterial cell, they are considered as the main tools for phage therapy. So today, we have learnt in detail about the structure of a bacteriophage, its mode of replication, namely lytic and lysogenic cycle, along with their differences. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.